Figma is my software of choice. I used to be a hardcore Sketch fan, but after having a quick play around with Figma, I realized the collaboration aspects of it was amazing and super useful when working within a product team. If you're new here, hi, what's up? I'm Gemma and I'm a senior UX UI designer who shares tips about UX for free. If that's something you're interested in, then why not hit that subscribe button? Turn on the notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. In this video, I'm going to show you how I set up my Figma files ready for product design. I have simplified the way that I set up this document just for educational purposes, but if you are just starting off using Figma for the first time yourself, then this is a good place for you to start. Without further ado, let's jump into Figma. First things first, all my projects have cover photos. The reason why I do this is so I can clearly see the difference between each of my projects, and it's a lot easier to locate those projects. Figma's file organization is not there just yet. Adding in cover photos allows your files to be easily located. So let's jump into one, shall we? This is where I put the cover photo to separate my files out from all the rest. I always start off with a project name and a short little introduction to the project. And I have this little progress bar as well, just so I can mark whether the project is in progress or complete or on hold or blocked. In the about section, I'm not going to cover what's in this section, as it's highly influenced by Femke Designs. She has a whole video around this and how you can organize your files, so I highly recommend that video and I will give a link to that in the description. The requirements section, this section is pretty awesome. So at the beginning of every project, we do a little requirements gathering exercise. This template came from Lean UX Canvas and it allows you to get a good understanding of some business problems, solutions, and it's just a good way of documenting some requirements if you don't have any to begin with. And what we like to do is pull each sticky note across, whatever the solution is, and then you have this all documented in this file. So whenever you need to come back and check your designs against requirements, you have this little handy template right here. In the research side, this is more of a dumping ground area. Right now there's nothing in my file, so I can't really show you any research that I've done. I like to add things which I found which is relevant to this project. Maybe I've seen another app which is similar to this, and maybe I like the way that they solve a problem. I add it here so that I can come back to refer to it a little bit later on. The wireframe section is pretty much self-explanatory. This is where I put all my wireframes. I always start every project with wireframes and work out some basic ideas before moving on to UI design. All wireframes pretty much live on their own frame. Then after I'm done with the wireframes, I will put them on an overall frame that I can call a category to keep them all contained. The reason why I do this is because on this page in general, they can have a whole array of different ideas. So in order to keep track of everything, I will put all the relevant wireframes onto one overall frame so then I can categorize it and come back to it later, especially if I need to explain ideas to anyone. It's the easiest way to find what I wanted to talk about. These little numbers across the top are normally tickets, so if we have a ticket that we need answering, which is in Jira or any other project management system that we're using, I'll always add in the ticket numbers at the top so I know which wireframes relate to what ticket. The wireframes also have a naming structure. I do this because I work with both mobile designs and desktop designs. The desktop would start with a D, and the name of the page would be the same. That's so when it comes to dev handoff, they can match up each design for desktop and mobile pretty easily. Handoffs. So this pretty much follows the same rules as the wireframing page, but it contains visual design this time. The naming conventions are still the same, and the layout is just the same. It's just the visual aspect now that has been applied on top of the wireframes. Prototypes. Again, pretty much self-explanatory. This is where all the prototypes live. Or, well, at least this one anyways. If there's multiple prototypes, then there'll be multiple prototype layers. But since there's only one in this document, then this is just the one that we will be viewing. Prototypes can come in various forms, so they don't always have visual design applied. Sometimes it could be just wireframes. And then I will name the prototype link accordingly. So it'd be prototype wireframes, prototypes UIs. But since it's just a quick introduction to how I technically lay out my files, then we're just gonna call it prototypes. These frames do not live on a category board because they are currently linked together. So if we press the little play icon at the top here, it should automatically open up a prototype of, yep, there we go. So now this prototype is clickable, and if anyone comes to view it, then they can kind of get a for what the product may end up looking like. So they can just click settings, go to dark mode, turn it on and off, go back. So by doing this, this will be really great for user testing. It's really good to hand over to stakeholders so they can see how their product is going to work. And it also gives the developers a heads up on how we expect it to work through transitions and things like that. And that's it. That's how I set up my Figma files for product design, UI design, UX design, whichever you want to call it. This is how I set up my Figma files. I hope you found this video useful. And if you do have any questions, then please let me know in the comments below. And last but not least, if you like this type of content, why not like and subscribe, turn on the notification bell to get notified every time I upload a new video. If you want to follow me over on Instagram, you can do so here. And until next time, bye!